Hey, what's up, guys? Alright. I cleared out the lower undead burg last time, and now, I mean, I guess we're actually gonna clear it out now.
Mm-hmm. I'm not up.
By trying to kill the Capra Demon. I will keep this one low on lore, I guess, because, I mean, this is not my favorite fight of the series. So, I can't imagine that we're gonna have a lot of fun with this episode here. Because I'm gonna be probably running back and forth just trying to kill this stupid Capra Demon. It's gonna be my health. I mean, at this point, I think I'm pretty good with, here, I don't wanna waste these necessarily, but, I mean, if I can kill them in one, two, that will work for me, so. I mean, the thing is, it's just very, don't have a lot of time to, you know, equip it. So you have to kind of just choose. It's all about the you know. Oh. Halthys leather armor. Lighter. Very close. Not much lore. All right. Well, here we go. Gonna do this, and I'm gonna do this, and I'm gonna do this, and I'm gonna do this. Oh, he still hit me. Well, didn't even get a swing in there. Fight all these guys every time. It's gonna be long enough. Ugh. Oh, I had souls on me too. That sucks, I forgot. It's not gonna make or break me, it's about 5,000, but, you know, instead of, like, just trying to, like, suicide, it probably behooves me to pick up those souls each time, which sucks. This is my lucky day. Okay. Gonna do the other pine resin. It's, you know, why not? Okay. Any problems? Okay. Well, that was easier. Well, let's read the key to the depths. Let's get some lore going on this. Key opening the door from the lower undead burg to the depths. Those banished from the undead burg eke out their existence in the depths. So, I mean, we already know that Lordran is like the land of undead now. We have the undead burg in there. And we know that lower undead burg is where all the, like, thieves and miscreants go. And now the ones that are not even worthy of lower undead burg go into the depths, a damp lair with no trace of sunlight. Nearly half of the depths form a perilous flooded labyrinth. And yes, that's where we're going to go today. Much sooner than I thought. Which is nice. Because if I can get past that guy, the sooner the better. Alright. Let's get in here. Let's go down, down, down. It was worth it. Didn't even use an Estus. Okay. Fire guys again. Oh god. It's just, you gotta approach these guys with shields apparently. I just didn't like doing that. I mean, whatever, I guess it's not my style of play. Butcher is coming after me. Oh, weird AI. That wasn't the most graceful thing, but yeah, so these butchers, I mean, they're very popularly, you know, described as women. I mean, they are women. And they just, you know, appear a little bulky, I guess. There's one up there in the rafters. But yeah, I mean, I guess they prepare the, you know, the unwanted, their meals, which could probably come from other unwanted things. Even more, even less unwanted. Or less wanted. Oh yeah, this is a great little item in here. This is a large ember. Let's read that real quick. Ember required for weapon ascension. A large, high-quality ember. Handled by blacksmiths of Astora. Well, we know that Andre's from Astora. And it goes from plus 5 to plus 10. And since we have plus 5, we're going to want to use that. This is a, you know, place we can go. I don't want to go there yet, but that's a, there's like a, you can get the spider shield that way. I think. What's timing? That was not. Alright. Not to worry, we're almost at a bonfire. Well, I guess we came up here, so we have to trigger back here. Oops. I wanted to roll past her. Yay! Zack's my favorite head. Really? Really? Well, I really have to get my endurance going. And you, here we now
yes,
see.
Yes, you! Here, over here! Please, you must help me.
Yeah, now we see another case of someone getting stuck in barrels.
Thank you. I would have been at supper without you. Been eaten alive, I started to think. Thank you. Thank you dearly. I am Laurentius, Lord the Great Swamp. I will not forget my debt to you. Oh, hello there. I'm fine, thanks to you. Oh, hello there.
I skipped some of this dialogue, whatever. Also, I didn't read the sack's description. Bloodstained patchwork sack by the undead man-eating cook lurking in the depths. Two aisles have been haphazardly cut out. It's unexpectedly soft and comfortable to wear, but is probably near meaningless in terms of defense. Well, it doesn't matter. I like the way it looks. But, yeah, so I guess they don't just eat the undesirables. They actually eat the undead in some form or another. Let's see if I can get this with. I'm gonna like equip this and be completely. Yeah, what the heck? I need to really. Do you not hit that? It's the worst trap ever. Huh. Gross. Hope none of them fall on my head. In this passage. Can I target this guy? No. Ugh. You should always take your time. Do it a lot less if you just take your time, but I'm impatient. I was moments away from a bonfire. And now I have to fight everyone again. Oh, look at that. Oh, it's locked. I forgot. Oops. Great axe. I think we read that one. Oh, wait, the battle axe. Not much. So yeah, here's the labyrinth as described. There's a little, oop, there's a normal size rat. There's a big size rat. Here's a rat leading you to an ambush, in a sense, although they don't really attack you all the time. There's the sewer chamber key, and there's a very large rat. Again, as I say, I believe that souls determine your size and that these aren't, you know, any special beings or anything. I think that these are all just... products on what they eat. In any community, a few bad apples are sure to exhibit insatiable greed. If they were turned undead and banished to the depths, would they reconsider their ways? Use this key to see for yourself. Well, I don't know if getting a bonfire here would make me see that, but... yeah, so... you know. If you didn't think, like, the depths was the worst of all things that could be considered, of course, after the depths you have. Blight Town. And let's kindle for fun. We got those humanity for free. So might as well use it while we have it. Alright. Oh, I guess we do have 18,000 souls, so... why don't we level up here? And now we're at 31. Let's start pumping endurance a little bit so that we can start, you know, actually carrying things. I mean, it doesn't give us a ton of stuff. I'm pretty much into physical attacks at this point. Nope, can't even do that. We got a ways to go before we like actually have another. We should go fight Havel, really. I'll kill these guys just in case. Oh. Okay. Just in case we can get some humanity. I mean, if I need to, I can always come farm it. Off camera. And yeah, I mean, this place is a little bit of a labyrinth if you haven't been here before. There's places you can drop down if you don't know where you're stepping. I believe this rat is only... Alright. Can you get a channeler? Can we just get these guys to come up? These guys can actually screw you up pretty badly. Okay, cool. Okay, that was pretty powerful. Alright, just come up here. Just stop. Oh, what? Wow. That was close. I didn't really plan on doing that. So yeah, that channeler will stand here during this fight that is held in this arena down here. And then once again, you kill him and he doesn't respawn. And otherwise he gives you a little bit of a hard time during the boss. Like if you rush towards the boss, he, you know, he can just... It's our first large Titanite. It's just a large shard, same description. But anyway, he can cause some troubles. Because his magic can start to hurt. Okay. Hear the basilisks that happen when you fall down. So I'm gonna, it's probably a bad idea, but I'm just gonna take this guy on. Because I believe just with so much damage, I think he's the only one. Oops. Wow. This is getting trapped against the wall. Not standing in between the wall and him. Once again, he gives you humanity. That's a spider shield, I believe. This is where you get the sewer key. And if you fall down here without going on the side, you will continue down into not a very nice place. So I'm gonna unlock this area and then willingly go straight into where the basilisks are. And I'm gonna rest at the bonfire, why not? I'm not gonna run into any enemies again. And I think this is gonna be our first invasion. I'm not sure if it's the first invasion of the game. Maybe I missed some. But I'm pretty sure I haven't. It's a servant of the, look at that. Servant of the fair maiden. That we will see quite a few times try to invade us. He's wearing a unique piece of weaponry, or armor, called the Armor of Thorns, where if he rolls into you, or if you otherwise touch it, you, oh my god. You will, get hurt. So yeah, this is a basilisk. They suck. One popular misconception is that those are its eyes right there, but those are decoys, and there's actually, it's not the best view of him, but his eyes are really small underneath. Oh, we can read about him through his spike shield all right away. You know, we don't have to wait till his armor appears. Oops, let's go down this way. Shield of the infamous Dark Wraith Kirk, Knight of Thorns, covered with spikes, can be used as a weapon. Sharp spikes cause heavy bleeding. Yeah, it says he's a Dark Wraith. It's a little confusing. I mean, I suppose he's probably a Dark Wraith. But he, when you kill all of him, all of his, all the times he invades you, he. You find him by the fair lady, so. So yeah, these are basilisks. I didn't say they spew out a thing that can turn you to stone, and in fact curse you. And when you get cursed by it, you die. And your health gets halved. I mean, I suppose most people playing would probably know that. But yeah, you can see the curse meter build up there. Yeah, and the only way to remove the curse is by getting the purging stone. So yeah, if you're going through this area like without ever really doing this game before, like, you will oftentimes fall down into these areas without knowing what you're getting into, and they will obviously take you off guard at that, in that way. But, you know, if you do it the normal way and you just come through here. Oh, this is a little weird item to get. It's like, oh no, it's not here. Never mind. Yeah, this is the Ring of the Evil Eye. I forgot about that. I might as well equip that. I don't have any other rings I want now. According to legend, this ring contains the spirit of the Evil Eye, a dark beast which assaulted Astora. The strength of the Evil Eye does not waver, and HP is absorbed from falling enemies. Kind of a cool little lore thing about Astora. Oh yeah, the item I'm thinking about is up here, actually. Oops. Get off me, basilisk. Yeah, it's like, you know, if this was a decent, cool item, it'd be kind of cool, but it's just like, I mean, I've killed all the basilisks, so there's no threat, but it's kind of like, you have to make a jump right on a turn, and then it's like, oh, well, it's for humanity. Okay. Whatever. I always think that that's weird. So, surprisingly, we're done with the depths. I mean, it's definitely more punishing to those who were unfamiliar with its ways than for those who have been through it many times. It relies on surprises and traps more often than it relies on, you know, actual difficulty. I mean, I have trouble more with Undead Burg than I'll often have with that area. So there's an interesting set of doors here. And it's locked and it's walled off by a gate, and that gate has been ripped apart from the inside out. Something has ripped itself out from wherever that door leads, or around here somewhere. It's kind of interesting. And this is Dom Hall of Xena, and he's a weird guy. He gives you a couple tips if you buy stuff from him, but for now he'll just talk to us. His armor's cool. He kind of looks like the Silver Knights, you know, with the horns they have.
Hi, Silver Knights. And good day to you. I'm Dawn of Xena. I'm just a peddler of sorts. I adore trinkets and oddities, so I trade for them.
This guy has to screw us up, so we'll have to kill him first, okay.
Hi, Shimon. I adore
him. Yeah. Okay. So he's gold pine resin. He has the bottomless box, which I'm just gonna buy. And then he has crystal stuff. A fully crystallized straight sword. How such a weapon was created is entirely unknown. The crystallization boosts its attack, but makes the blade brittle. The sword cannot be used long, and it cannot be repaired. Crystal, huh? It's kind of interesting. Different, new. And then he has his, apparently he sells his own armor off his back. I mean, it's not off his back, because if you buy it, he's still dressed. But Helm of the Wise. A strange helm from the ancient land of Xena, birthplace of the curious dealer Dom Nall. The two ends are believed to symbolize wisdom. The many metals are believed to symbolize glory. The gold bracelets symbolize a vanquisher, and the inlaid silver rings symbolize an explorer.
Hmm. Well, I'm certain we will make a good trade eventually, so I am willing to share some tips. If you see kindling in the catacombs, use divine weapons. That will repel the reassembling skeletons.
Wow. That's about as explicit as you can get. I didn't know he gave you tips without buying.
I'm afraid I don't see anything here.
That's usually what he says right there.
Thank you. That was a fine trade. I have this. Oh, I bought the bottom. We'll meet again soon. We'll make another fine trade, of course.
Gotcha. So yeah, you gotta keep buying stuff from him in order to get more tips from him. Top tips. Alright. And then here we are. Now we're at the boss here, which is great. This is another place where I'm like, oh, there's an item here somewhere. Also, there's more than one summon here. Is it? It's not. Machek again, is it? We shall see. I feel like there's crossbow bolts somewhere in here. Okay, so we have Night Solaire and Lautrec. Wow! It seems like our paths are intertwined, and there's the bolts. Okay. Let's get Lautrec. And let's get, oh, can you only do one? I mean, I don't want Lautrec if you can only do one. Okay. In this game, if you summon them and then go to the boss, so like when you summon people, the bosses have more health or have more resistance or whatever. And if you have two, it, you know, it's double. If you summon them like that and then run into the fog wall and start the boss fight before they're fully summoned, it'll, you know, it'll count as they'll have lower health or whatever. But, you know, I'm just summoning for fun, so let's just, go ahead with this. I love this entrance. By the way, they show this little head, like a snake, an alligator. It's like, oh my god, is that gonna be a really fast enemy? Oh my god! It's a really small head on a big, toothful stomach. From Software has used this enemy design for a lot of things. To have the rib cage kind of represent teeth. Okay, well, since I'm not doing, I was doing this with Sorcery last time. That was a lot harder to do. Oh, I think I can cut off his tail actually. It's gonna be a weird fight with this guy. There you go. Dragon King Great Axe. We'll obviously look at that later. One kind of cool thing about this is I mean, you can cut off all, Okay, get out of here. You can cut off any tail in this game. I've obviously done the gargoyles, and I've done this guy, I'll do more, of course. It now affects his moveset. Like, he used to swing, you know, his tail at me or whatever. He actually is incapable of doing that. Oh god. So the easiest way to kind of deal with this guy is to let him not grab you. Is to let him, yeah. Oh, that's the wrong one. I'm not really sure what this does to you. It doesn't seem to hurt you. There, I missed it. So, just to get him to put his head down. Charges. Puts his head back up. I don't know if that, like, ruins your equipment, slows you down, hurts you. I was getting screwed by this walk here, so I never even wanted to take chances with it, but I think I got it here, so. Okay, that's keeping Dragon down. Obviously, it's also a lot of track and Solaire down. You get a 20 manus from that. Don't know why. for all the theories that are going around, I don't know that that can explain that. Standard hard leather stuff. Those are all, I think, you know, every starting equipment in the game can be found. I already found, like, the sorcerer's set, for example. Let's read the Blighttown key. Key to Blighttown from the depths of the undead burg, swallowed by the gaping dragon. As its name suggests, Blighttown is a place of great pestilence. Even the polluted inhabitants of the depth are aware of its dangers and built this mighty door in hopes that they would remain safely separated. So, the people from the depths were the ones that tried to protect themselves against Blighttown. So once again, Fromm is having a little fun with all this, saying, like, there's obviously outcasts, and then there's outcasts of outcasts, and there's outcasts of outcasts of outcasts. I suppose it's supposed to scare you a little bit. It's like, well, I thought Undeadburg was terrible. I thought the lower Undeadburg was terrible. I thought the depths were terrible, and where am I? You get the point I'm trying to make. But Blighttown is legitimately, like, a crazy place. Depths, not so much. It's kind of like the Princess Bride. Those who know the secrets of the fire swamp. Get out alive. Well, here I am. I came back so I could level up here, and so we could do things before I go down into Blighttown. So, let's go up to 15 here. Let's start doing some vitality too, you know, just to give us a little bit more survivability, make it a little easier on us. Okay. Next episode, we're gonna try out the Blighttown.